Y'all come on in now. Come right on down front. I got something I want to show you. Now, y'all heard of the popcorn? Y'all heard of the dog? You heard about all them other dances. But now that's a brand new dance that's going around, I want to show you exactly what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the funky chicken. Y'all ready? I said y'all ready. Okay, here we go. You raise the left arm up and the right arm too. Let me tell you just what to do. Start boom on the drumming. Start the beat the kicking. That's when you know you're doing the funky chicken. Second spell. You put both arms up across your face. Your knees start wiggling and your feet start kicking. Then you know you're doing the funky chicken. Oh, I'm feeling it now. I feel so unnecessary. This is the kind of stuff to make you feel like you want to do something nasty. Like weigh some chicken gravy on your white shirt. Wrap down front. Here we go, y'all. Your white bone arms and your white bone feet. You're the baby. You're right on the beat. You flap your arms and your feet start kicking. Then you know you're doing the funky chicken.
I'm Good evening. Hello. Come on in. This is the place to be. Now on Thursday nights. And the reason why we are on Thursday and Sunday night is because it is because of all you wonderful and beautiful melanated people. So if you are in the trenches, come on in and join us in the chat room. Let us know where you're coming from, whether it be California, New York City, I don't care. Just come on in and take a seat, and we're gonna chop it up. That's what we do around here. But before I get started, I got to welcome everyone. If you are a person who always tunes in, we want to say welcome back. And we will get to the chat room at the end of my program this evening. So don't worry, I will acknowledge you in the chat room, but I can't do that coming in. But I do want to say welcome. And for all of the newcomers, if you are new to the channel, I need for you guys to do a couple of things so you guys can sit back. I need for you guys to go ahead, click, like, and subscribe, and then share this video are multiple reasons why we need you to like. We need for to get the thumbs up on the likes. It's not so, I mean, I know you like me. The thumbs ups is basically to tell the program of the tube that you want to see more of me. Yes, that's what the thumbs up really, really, truly means. It means that you are liking the program and you want to see more of me. So with doing that, you got to go ahead and put the thumbs up, okay? Also, I would like to make everybody a VIP to my group. Now, what that means, let me tell you what that means and why you are here. Okay, I want you to get, I want it to be a full understanding. This channel is all for adult content. Okay, when I say adult content, we talk about adult conversations. I'm not saying that we're not rated X, but we sure can get close to a rated R around here. we talk about adult context. We will be offering music groups and celebrities. We will be offering people who are promoting their band, promoting their music. If they are an artist, if they have a movie trailer, if they have a new book that they want to present on the show, we are here to promote it. And the reason why we are equipped to promote it is because we are now global. That's right. We are not just in one country. We are in several countries. And that means that the tube can't stop us. I mean, like McFadden says, ain't no stop. We didn't turn on that knob and we didn't took this mug into orbit. So it's no restriction in where that the queen can go. Because guess what, folks? On Thursdays and Sundays, it's the queen's time. And when you come into this channel, you're going to get, I mean, we got discount travel. We got gift certificates. We got, oh, man, we got so much. Matter of fact, let me make travel parties. We talk about how we can bring about the community. We talk about how to get our black men or I should say how to keep our black men out of prison. We talk about all the old school remedies. Y'all remember when mama and grandmama used to tell you that if you had an upset stomach that you are supposed to eat 2 tablespoons of mustard and take your butt to bed? Yeah, see, that still applies today. But the thing is, it's a lot of these new people that they just don't simply understand that. So they need people from the old school, because that's what basically, folks, this is what we are basically about. We are bringing back the old school. We are promoting music bands. We are promoting musicians. We are promoting movie stars, celebrity, all on the front right here with the Carino Radio. We've been doing it for over 36 years, and it can't change now. That's all I'm saying. And so the list goes on and on. Now, also what we want to, before we get in, before I want to let this be known, we don't do any gossiping around here. I just want everybody to know that, learned about who slept with whom and why they slept with that person. We don't get on this show to do no signifying. We don't go back and forth with the derelicts and the hood rats that want to sit up and go from channel to channel talking about each other and being all negative. We try to keep everything positive on this channel, as well as fun. Like I said, this is the adult channel. We are fun and we are very informative. So if you are interested in learning all about that you can possibly learn about being a true, real, bona fide adult, then you are in the right spot. Now, before I get into tonight's presentation, I just want everybody to know we talk about everything around here. We don't discriminate. We talk about sex. We talk about drugs. We talk about courts. We talk about current events. We even talk about athletic foot if it's get funky enough up in here where we need to let the windows up. That's all I'm saying. We talk about everything over here that needs to be an address or concern. But like I said before, we do not gossip. We don't care about people's personal lives and what people do in their clothes facilities or buildings or whatever the case may be. Topic on this show, just for all of my new people that is coming in, I see that you guys are coming in, and I just want you to know why it's so important. Coming up, also coming up in September, matter of fact, it's the second week of September. The second week of September, my sponsors will be allowing me to give away free gifts. And these gifts are extremely expensive for my VIPs. It doesn't matter whether you have come in today or came in yesterday or came in last month. You are qualified and bona fide to get a free gift off of the Queen of Radio sponsorship channel in September. So I need for you guys to mark your calendars. I need for you guys to mark your calendars for the second week of September, because it's going to be going on around here. We're going to be giving away so much travel and so much gift certificates and so much free hotel stays in honor of my birthday, because, you know, I feel like my birthday need to be celebrated. But then again, everybody's birthday need to be celebrated. So if your birthday is in September, then we're going to be planning on giving you a big old shout out as well. Okay. Now, before I get into the groove of tonight, I got to talk about what's been going on in the news. Now, I got three things I need to mention about what's going on in the news. First and foremost, I have seen a video, and this is going to be questionable. Like I said, I don't get into people's personal business, but this channel, I don't even know if it's a channel. I believe it was more like a post that I saw. I saw a post of Dr. Dre, okay? And what puzzled me was the fact of the post. The post said that he has made his daughter to be homeless. Now, I'm saying to myself, what type of relation? And, you know, you go, I mean, how did he get to that homeless? So I'm kind of questioning about that, because, you know, that's not something that's very favorable. So if anybody out there that tunes in or listen to Dr. Dre, y'all may need to pass a message on to him that we're kind of curious about why is it that his daughter is homeless, and indirecting about why this girl, this young lady, is living out on the streets. That's a question. I have to ask a question anytime I see my fellow melanated people being out there on the streets. So that's a question. If anybody, you know, want to check into that and get back to me and let me know what, you know, what's going on. Why would they go through those extremes to where you would put your own child, your own flesh and blood, out on the street? Okay, the second announcement that I got to make, there has been in the news, it just came to me, that the officer in the case with Mr. Wallace has recently passed away. Know the gist of it just yet? I can't tell you, but I will say this. I need for everybody to come back on Sunday, because we're going to chop it up. Y'all don't even know. I got a lot to say. Oh, do I have a lot to say? So, for Sunday's show, we're going to put it up there where we're going to have an open discussion about all of that. We're going to talk about what to my knowledge, I can only give you what I know from my own personal knowledge of the situation. I'm going to talk about my opinion. I'm going to give you my two cents about the whole ordeal. And if you haven't seen the show already, I have already had done a video in reference to Florida about 2 weeks ago. If you guys want to check the archives, if you haven't seen it, please feel free to go ahead and check it out at your leisure. And the third thing that I need to make an announcement about, you guys from the last program, first of all, I want to say thank you. Okay. First, I want to say thank you for all of the people who trust me and have the ability to trust me to do what I do. Now, it has been brought to my attention through you guys have been emailing me. I know that you guys have been not only watching the program live, but you also have been watching it, you know, after the show is over with and you're going back into the archives. The last show that I did, I believe I was on the show with my good friend Greg Lassiter, which, by the way, that rating of that show is just going through the rooftops. And I'm pretty sure if he was here, he would be thanking you as well. But my concern is this. People from the last show had emailed me in reference to collecting donations on behalf of Grandmaster Jay. Now, I want to make this clear. Now, I'm going to tell y'all this. Nobody can love Grandmaster Jay more than me and more than anybody will ever know. I got much love and I got much respect for the man. However, I wanted to be known to everybody that I do not, and I want to make this clear, I have never had any permission, okay, to accept any donations on behalf of Grandmaster Jay. So what I have been told, that if people come through my channel talking about donations for Grandmaster Jay, and please, I want y'all to know this, I'm not discouraging you. I want you to support this man to the best of your ability. Because like I said before, I have just as greatest love for Grandmaster Jay than anyone. As for Grandmaster Jay, he has asked that everybody put that on hold until he can come up and make a public announcement as to how he wants his donations to be sent to him. So I say again, I appreciate that you have thought so much. You guys have thought so much to, you know, the fundraisers and all this other stuff, but I have not been given any permission. I want to make that clear. I have not been given any permission to collect any money or to do any fundraising on behalf of Grandmaster Jay. Now, I will say this. If that should ever change, I will let everybody know. But as of now, I believe that he is taking care of some more, I guess you could say, some more important business that needs to be taken care of. So it has been told to me that for all the people who love him just as much, to put it on hold. I didn't say not to give it to him. It's just that he wants to be able to make the decision as to where and how he wants to proceed with people giving him donations for his cause, okay? So, like I said again, I appreciate y'all emailing me saying that you want me to hold something for gravity right now. I'm not at liberty, and that will have to be at the final decision of Mr. Grandmaster Jay, okay? So we're going to continue to send our love. Yes, we are. We're going to continue to send our love for the man in the trenches. But we are sitting in the pockets waiting on further instructions by him as to what he would like for us to do. Because me, myself, folks, I don't like to be yelled at. I don't want nobody yelling at me for doing the wrong thing or saying the wrong thing. So My whole thing is I'm going to stay in my lane. I'm going to stay in the Queen of Radio's lane. That way, can't nobody blame me for nothing, okay? But I was told to put that out there. Grandmaster Jay will get back. He will get back to all of his loyal and loving fans and followers in reference to what he wants to do in reference to all of the donations, okay? So I just wanted to throw that out there just to, you know, to clear up any misunderstandings about where I sit with the whole thing. I do not have any permission to do anything in reference to that. So with that being said, we're going to just keep on moving right along. Yeah, because, you know, I like to stay on point and I like to stay on my topics. Tonight, we're going, like I said, we're going to be playing some music. Like I said, I have sat up with my production company. And they said, you can go ahead and continue to see, you guys want the music. And I don't blame you because I love old school music, too. So what this is how we're going to solve this problem. In order for you guys to get the real old school music during the shows, you're going to have to come in and watch the show live. Yes, you're going to have to watch the show live, because once this becomes a recorded version of the show, the production company that is in place is going to change all of the music that I have started with and ended with. So it will not be, it'll be the same content, but it will not be the same music other than live. So I don't want y'all to say, oh, wait a minute, I heard her play this song, and then when we heard it again, it was edited. Well, yes, I'm letting y'all know that in advance. The production company will be editing all of the videos by taking off the other type of music and putting my own music of my own band up there. And then they're going to make it do what it do. So I don't want y'all to go into a shock. The music, I you know, y'all know me. I do not play the same type of song on every show. Every show is themed. Every show has a theme. And tonight's theme, we're going to talk about great sex for old people over 50, that is. And we're going to talk about great soul food and how to lose weight the healthy way, okay? But I did want to bring out those announcements first. Now, I'm glad that y'all are here. I am so glad y'all are here. Y'all are coming on in. Thank you so much. I want to thank you for all of the love messages, and you guys go ahead and use the page after the show is over with. Look, folks, that posting page is your page. I need y'all to know that. The page after the page that you see under the description of the show, and be boisterous about anything. If you want to leave a message for someone, if you want to leave a message for Jay, go ahead, leave a message for him, and I'm pretty sure he will be somewhere circling around to notice all the messages that you leave for him. Please do not leave any personal information on the page. If you got personal information that you want me to know or him to know, I am more than welcome to, you're more than welcome to send me an email at atorclass101@gmail.com. Like I said before, we will be having a lot of old school bands coming on this show for the future. We got some performers. We got some comedians that will be in the building. We got some professional people. We got all types of people that will be coming on this show from near and far to keep on to share that up. Now that I've gotten all of that wonderful stuff out the way, now I can talk about the goodies. Yeah, the goodies. I'm gonna share two stories with you about bad sex, okay? We're going to talk about bad sex, because like I told you, we talk about everything on this program. Now, before I can get into that, I want everybody to know, you know, I want to talk about the age difference here. I want to start off with that. You see, when you turn, let me tell y'all something. See, people who are in there, who are turning 40, you ain't got enough sense just yet. You are at that cornerstone. You understand? See, because when you turn 40 and you're starting to get into where you're doing less game, we're gonna back all of this mess up, you know. And what is so phenomenal about getting older, you see things just a little bit differently. You know what I'm saying? See, when we were young, I got to say this. When we were young, you know, when we were in our teens and we were coming up and we were doing this, that, and the third, you know, the little boys, they were so mannish. Every time you turned around, they wanted to have sex, right? Y'all remember that? Y'all remember when it, you know, they would bet on how much Kool-Aid you would exchange sex for Kool-Aid glasses. I'm telling you, we did some crazy stuff back in the day when you exchanged sex for Kool-Aid. I mean, that got to be some hellified Kool-Aid. I kid you not. We had, you know, but anyway, back in the day, the little boys would always want to have sex. They were trying to find ways, you know, to be Mr. Pokemon. See, we're going to keep it clean. I told you, we don't do X-rated. We might get close to maybe rated R around here, but we're not going to do X-rated. But anyway, these little boys, y'all all remember when these little boys were trying to find themselves. And so, you know, at a young age, girls didn't care too much for sex. And I'm going to tell you why we didn't care too much for sex, because we had a strict grandmother. We had a strict mama. Mama said that means that you got them open too quick. Yeah. See, you had to take the dime and the quarter test. If that quarter dropped, then that means you, nope. And see, back in the day, mama didn't play around with people, you know, with you getting pregnant. See, we would be so concerned, you know, when we were young. I'm talking about the girls now. The girls didn't like having sex at a young age because it was like, oh, no, because it comes with responsibilities. And you know, pregnancy, we had to worry about condoms. We had to worry about yeast infection. Wear those extra cotton underwear. Y'all remember that? And so, you know, we had, you know, back in the day, we had a lot of concerns. The reason why sex was not really something we wanted to do, you know, back, you know, for the girls anyway. You know, the boys, he didn't care. You know, the wind could blow. You know, he had a woody. He had a wood chip with a woody and the woody woodpecker. But girls was like, no, player, because I can't be doing this. I can't be doing this children's thing. You know, and some of them would wind up having, you know, 5 and 6 kids and, you know, keep doing the nasty instead of being into the books. See, I was a kid that I had to stay in the books. You know, I had a strict set of parents. My mother would be so strict. She would come on the date with me. That's how strict she was. She said, where you taking my child tonight? Mm-hmm. Here come the questions. But the movie theater, they used to call it the movie box. You know, they didn't call it, you know, mama would say, well, how long you gonna be at that movie box, girl? And what time is that movie over? And you better be back in this house by 10:05, no less than 10:04. You know, so we had instructions. We didn't, you know, back in the day, we could not, well, at least I couldn't. I can't speak for anybody else. We couldn't enjoy sex the way that we wanted to enjoy it. So as we had gotten older, that kind of changed. Because I have noticed that when you get to be 50 years old, that sex drive is a whole lot different. I mean, now we want a Kool-Aid smile. Now we want a Kool-Aid smile. Back, see, you know, because now, hell, when you're 50 years old, sex is free. When I say free, let me classify that, because y'all will be like, it's free? No, what I mean is, by when I say that it's free, we're free out of our head. We're not in that process where we feel like we're going to get pregnant, because by the time, if you ain't done, you're having a bearing children by 50, you can pretty much hang it up, you know, because having kids at 50, we ain't doing nothing but a gas bubble. You know, we that's the only thing we talking about, let loose and let go, is a gas bubble. That's all we're interested in at the age of 50. I'm just letting y'all know that. But I will tell you this. There are some secrets, and y'all gonna need to write these secrets down, because, you know, as a man, I'm gonna tell you about a man. Oh yeah, see, I've had my fair share of them. But before I tell you the secrets, I want y'all to know about two experiences. I'm gonna tell y'all two delight. Well, one of the stories, and I'm gonna tell you something. These stories are absolutely true. Okay, now, you know, as women, and I gotta say this, when you reach the age of 50, you have seen it all and you have done it all pretty much when it comes to these sexual encounters. Now, I'm not going to talk about all of my exes. I'm not going to do that. I'm not going to put them out on blast, but there are two of them that I really, really got to talk about. You know, I'm going to talk about Patrick first. Patrick is what I call, you know, Patrick could never grow up to be a golfer. And when I say he can't be a golfer, every time you look around, that brother misses the hole. I kid you not. You could give that brother some bifocals. He still want to miss it. Don't ask me why. Don't ask me how. He just misses it. So I had gotten to the point of calling, you know, I had to get to the point of calling Patrick the cheese grater. Y'all, you women know what I'm talking about when I say the cheese grater. You know, the type of brother that always think he got it and he can't even find it. You got to give him some, you need to give him a pair of magnifying glasses and special lenses to help him to, you know, to move it around. And then he had the audacity. Patrick. Yes. Patrick had the audacity to be huffing and dude, hold him up. Look here. I call him part of the thigh. You know, when you know he's still missing it, be like, he huffing and puffing. Boy, let me tell you what I did. And see, I get mad. It's more of a benefit for a man than it is for a woman. I kid you not. Anyway, Patrick was so bad. He's sitting up there huffing and puffing. Do you know I literally left his ass? I left him and I said, dude, if you're going to do all that huffing and puffing, here is a broom and a mop. Have my house clean by the time I get back. That's what you do. Because you ain't doing nothing. The bedroom is not your forte. You need to go back to the study books. If there were ever any study books, Patrick needed to learn. I kid you not. So anyway, the next bad experience that I want to talk about, and this one, y'all gonna see, I know y'all gonna laugh about this. I'm telling y'all, y'all are gonna laugh at this and y'all are gonna go tell somebody about this story. But this is a true story, and I hate to do this to Riley. Yeah. His name was Riley. Okay. Now, the problem with and see, this is a horror story, but it's also kind of funny, if depending on how you look at it. Okay. Now, Riley called himself being into the adult toys. Okay. Y'all know what I'm talking about them special adult toys that you go to the, you know, so you go and you find these little playthings and these little whatever, this, that, and the third. Now, let me tell you what Riley did, and Paul Riley, and I'm still praying for this man. I'm pretty sure he's a man. If he's still living, I don't really know. But Riley was called himself trying to impress me, okay? And you and there are some men that try to impress a woman, with all of his body moves and all this other stuff, right? So anyway, Riley went to the adult store and picked up this accordion bag type gadget contraption. I call it a contraption, okay? Now, he was excited about using this contraption on making himself to be a little bit larger. Y'all know what I'm talking about. And I don't need to give the details about that. You know what I'm saying? So anyway, he went and had this paper accordion bag, right? And it looked like a blow bag. It looked like something that you could like blow up like a balloon or something. And it had like a little twist tie knobs. It had this little drawstring. That's what it was. It was a drawstring. Had these little drawstrings on the sides of it to where you drew it together. And now here come the funny humor part of this story. Riley put this little accordion type ripple type bag on his Woody, because that's what we're gonna call it. He put this thing on his Woody, and then the next thing, and he drew this thing real tight, right, like it was supposed to make it puff up like Superman or something, right? So the next thing I know, you know, the next thing he know, all of a sudden he opened the bag and him and the Woody was gone. This is a true story. Now, I said, you know, I'm sitting up there thinking that, okay, well, maybe he lost it in the table and some foreskin. I kid you not. We looking all up around the bag to see did he lose it on the other end or did it fall out of this accordion type bag? Did it get locked? Did it get chopped up? Did it fall out? Did it fall in the apartment heater vent? We looked, I'm telling you folks, this man was completely embarrassed. I mean, if a man could ever be embarrassed for his Woody to completely fall off, I mean, at first, I'm going to tell you something. At first, I said to him, I said, you know, are you sure? You know, I'm thinking that was a great magic trick. You know, I'm like, man, that's some magic to make your Woody disappear. But it didn't disappear. It fell off. And to this day, here it is. And I don't know if Riley has ever found his Woody. We moved furniture around. We had to move the couch. We moved the pillowcases. We looked all over for that body part. I said, so I told him, I said, well, maybe you need to go to the hospital. Maybe they got a remedy for you. You know, I tell you, you satisfy their sexual desires because, you know, if it gets to the point where you lost your Woody, and we couldn't find it in the accordion bag, that little ripple bag. We don't know what the hell happened to it. So I don't know. I mean, I don't know. Maybe at this point, maybe Riley has turned himself into a girl. I really don't know. But it was a strange, you know, it was a very, 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 very strange situation to a person to have, you know, lost their body parts. So if you are out there, I hope you don't, maybe you should read the instructions. Next time you go, off all you men that likes those exotic toys or from the adult store, maybe you should read the instructions first on how to use it, because I would hate for you to be one of those people that wake up one morning and all your body parts is gone. That was just simply amazing for me to even see. And that's a true story. I mean, I kid you not, I am mesmerized as the fact that, man, either that was an extremely good magic trick that Riley had did, or he just was lost. That, you know, that's all I can that's all I can tell you on that. So anyway, as you get older, for all of the men, yeah, they don't like to hear about that might cause them to have a nightmare or something. But as you get older, in all truth of the matter, men tend to lose their sex drive. They really do. It's like now when you get to be the age of 50, they will find everything else under the sun to do. They'll go play with the dogs. They'll go fishing. They'll go, you know, they'd rather even go horseback riding at this point than to be engaged in anything, you know, on the sexual tip. So, and what I found out through recent studies, that the reason why, this is a case scenario, is because that it's a blood circulation type problem. It's a drive. So here are the three secrets that men need to have to get that sex drive. Now, see, guys, if you're not having sex at least twice a month, you know, y'all may need to check your vowels. That's all I'm going to tell you. You just need to check your motor skills. You know those plugs and things. So, but anyway, there are three things that a man can increase his sexual drive without using the blue pill. Mm-hmm. They have shown that the three ingredients, you can either use grape juice or wine, anything with the grape substance or some type of form. Or grape juice, you need to have king cobra, and you need to have ginseng. Ginseng is to help you remember the memory block about having that, be like, oh, it was a night to remember, but you can't remember a damn thing. So those are the secret ingredients to help a man with his sex drive. Also, for women with a sex drive. Yeah, because, you know, women have to have a sex drive too. And we're not afraid to talk about sex on the show. We just want to keep it clean. Anyway, women, dark chocolate and strawberries. Dark chocolate. Now, you see why you need to be ordering from your favorite, like, Sherry Berries. Oh, they have the most wonderful chocolate-covered strawberries. Chocolate, dark chocolate, has what they call a sexual stimuli. It's an ingredient in all chocolate, whether you have a Hershey bar or you know, M&M's or whatever, a Snicker bar. That chocolate has a stimuli in the chocolate form. Now, I will tell you this, and what I found out through searching, you cannot eat pork and chocolate together, because they have found out through the recent study that it causes heart failure. So we know that you want to get your groove on, but you want to be safe. You don't want to be, it's because they're, you know, pork and chocolate, you know, chocolate isn't what they call an antibiotic type deal. It kind of helps you to smooth out things and ailments and stuff. So you don't want pork and chocolate to be fighting for a position in your stomach, because that could cause all kind of heart problems at the end. So please do not mix your pork products. I don't see me myself. I don't even eat pork. I stopped. I found out that when I had to stay in a hospital for 3 months after being sick off of eating chili, and the lady had put pork in the chili, I could not, you know, I was in the hospital for 3 months, and I said I would never, ever eat any more pork products. So, but the ones who can eat pork, and the ones who enjoy pork products, like your pork chops and your what is it, that bacons and stuff, you know, y'all like all that pork stuff, be careful with auditor. Making sure that you're not eating pork and mixing it with any, like, turn around and eat a chocolate bar, because it will mess up your whole system down there. So now, another good thing about that men over 50. Yeah, y'all can say what y'all wanted to, but see, when men hit over 40. When men, no, it's not even over 40. When men hit over 50, they are looking for quality, not quantity. See, back in the, you know, y'all remember, like I said, back in the day, men would have women coming out of the four, you know, back and forth, this, that, and the third. More interested in having a woman that they are very much compatible with. And I remember there used to be a lady, a sex therapist named Dr. Joyce Brothers. I will never forget when Dr. Joyce Brothers came on the Oprah Winfrey Show. I believe it was either the Oprah Winfrey Show or one of the shows that was going on back then. And she said that in order for a man to increase his love life and his stimulus naturally, he would have to sleep naked with the woman of his, you know, his wife, and their legs in what they call a crisscross lock position. Where he's on the back and she's on the front. And I was like, wow, you know, well, I can't wait. You know, I can't wait to spoil somebody rotten when I get married. But I'll never forget that how she was very, you know, she was very adamant about people getting up in age and their sex drive is a little bit different than how it was when they were younger. So for older men to do the crisscross, they call it the leg crisscross with the one you love, and it's normally done naked, and that's normally when you're sleeping. I was just really, really amazed to learn all these things about what causes the man's sex drive to go, you know, higher when they turn that 50, because it's like right now when you turn 50, they'd rather do every other things than to be with the one that they supposedly love. So okay, guys, so that brings it back to the bedroom. Okay, now, how do you lose weight? Got to do that part, and then I'm going to get my butt out of here. I'm going to tell y'all how I lose weight. I'll tell you what my resume was. Now, at the beginning of May of this year, I was at, back in May of this year, I was weighing about 185 pounds. And so that has, you know, I don't feel comfortable when I got that much weight on me. So what I had to do was, I said, okay, Linda, you know, you got to get back to being 155. Okay. So first thing I do, and see, I've already said this to you, you got to do some form of an exercise. Now for my exercise, I walk, I do walking. I'm not a part of a gym. I walk 4 miles a week, 2 miles going in and 2 miles coming back. And I have on my walking track shoes. So when I'm walking, I'm not running, getting the circulation going. And also, what I do for myself is I count my calories around 155, because that way I don't have to change my clothes. I don't have to get rid of my clothes. I can keep my clothes. My clothes are the same size that I've been wearing all my entire life. Now, at the beginning of May, I was 185 pounds, 84 pounds. Now I am 164. Yes, I am 164, the weight that I'm looking to get to. Now, how did, everybody keeps asking me, how did I do it? Okay, now by incorporating your walking, doing something as simple as walking, if you are the type of person who works at home, I work at home. So I'm always inside of the house. So, but I have to make a point to get outside of the house. I can't walk my dogs anymore. I used to walk dogs, but no, no more. I may go and walk somebody else's dog. I may have to go borrow, you know, I go borrow Sheba. You know, I go borrow Sheba and go walk her. But other than that, I don't be outside as much, because 90% of my business is at home. So since my business is pretty much at home on phones and talking and researching, and I'm always on the internet, I have to find a way to get healthy. So what I have to do, if you are trying to get in the frame of 155 pounds or 175 pounds and down, your calorie intake needs to be at 2,000. You cannot go past 2,000 in calories per day. Now, I'm going to tell you how I did it with my calorie intake. I would take yogurt. By the time lunchtime, doing dinner, at dinner time, I use my heavy meal at lunchtime. I switch it up because I have time to burn off that fat. I have time to burn it off up until it's time to go to bed. By the time I go to bed, now around lunchtime, I'm going to have maybe a half of a sandwich. I'm not eating a whole sandwich. You have to decide to cut that sandwich in half. You cut the sandwich in half and have it for another day. Now, you put it with a cup of fruit. You put it with a proportion of chips or whatever it is that you eat. You see, I don't eat pretzels or anything, but I do love my Cheetos. Ooh, I love me some Cheetos. And I love me some cheddar cheese popcorn. So I'm gonna proportion that for my lunch, even though I'm gonna increase my calories for my lunchtime. For my lunchtime, I'm eating somewhere between 800 calories. And then by the 800 calories plus 200 calories, that's only 1,000. By the time I get to dinner time, I'm only gonna use about maybe 600 if I got meatloaf. Whatever, and folks, I have not stopped cooking old school, okay? You can still eat old school meals. You can eat your collard greens. You can eat your macaroni and cheese. You can eat your fried chicken. But instead of having two pieces of fried chicken, you literally. Now, there is some things that you need to know. And some people ask me, Linda, how do you cook greens? Okay. Now I'm gonna give y'all my secret for cooking greens and how to use the greens to lose weight. Okay, you want, for you, no matter whether you have had your heaviest meal at 12 noon or 2 o'clock in the afternoon, you want to be able to put some of these top ingredients in your food. Now, people ask me, how do you cook greens? Okay, well, first of all, you got to buy the greens that you like. You got collard greens, you got kale, you got turnips and mustards, whatever type of greens you like. I cut them up and I wash them thoroughly, as you know, you're supposed to wash the greens because you don't know what farm they came from. Now, pretty soon I'll probably be getting back into growing my own veggies. But for now, I have to buy these things at the grocery store. Now, after you wash your greens and you cut up your greens, you put them in a pot, you choose the type of meat that you want to use. My pressure cooker, I use a pressure cooker to where the meat falls completely off the bone. Yes, you can still, I'm telling you, if you want to keep a man, I'm trying to tell y'all, you talking about man over 50, that man over 50 will stay at home with a woman who can cook. And you won't have to worry about his sex drive. He'll be walking around in the daytime with a flashlight looking for you. That's what I'm talking about. You give that man a succulent steak. I'm talking about a type of steak to where you can use a fork to go through the flakes of the steak. I'm not talking about a steak where you got to cut it and you got to hit that steak up against the wall. You know, that's some patent leather type stuff going on there. You don't want to eat that crap. Now, but anyway, and then you get you some seasoned skillet potatoes. You cut up, you dice and slice those potatoes. You put your potatoes and onions and some bell peppers and say, shut the front door and lock the back. That's what I'm talking about. Now, and see, that's old school, y'all. See, everybody now wants to go to the fast food restaurant. They like, you can't bust a no type of Woody's with going to a McDonald's. McDonald's is not a Woody type restaurant. I'm just trying to tell you. Now, anyway, cut up the greens. Now, you only use, instead of using vegetable oil, you use 2 tablespoons, nothing less, nothing more. You use 2 tablespoons of coconut oil. Coconut oil needs to be in all types of food products. And this is the number one secret of losing weight, people. This is how I personally lost weight from May. Now I only got 9 more pounds to go. I only got 9 more pounds and I've been consistent. Whatever I cook, you only want to put in 2 tablespoons of coconut oil. See, people say, well, isn't it going to taste like coconut? No, it's not going to make your food taste like coconut. Coconut oil is the type of oil that will blend in to whatever flavors that you're working with. It will become a chameleon. It will turn itself in to whatever. Another ingredient that helps you to lose weight while you sleep is cinnamon. You have to put cinnamon in anything that's warm, like a drink. You can use it like in hot beverages. You can use it in breads. You can use it in whatever it is. Like for my candied sweet potatoes, oh my goodness. I got to use not only the vanilla, I got to use the vanilla and the nutmeg, and I got to use the cinnamon, but that cinnamon has to be proportioned. See, folks, I tell you, I take food to another level. Everybody and their mama comes to my house. All I got to do is just call one. You know, when you can cook so good, you call one person and they'll call the rest of the people to round them up to meet at your house at a certain time on Sunday. You know, for that Sunday dinner when you got that skillet cornbread going on, the smoked turkey, you got the chicken in the dressing, you got the candied yam, you got the mac and cheese. Y'all know what I'm talking about. That's how you do it. Now, that you say you want to keep your man at home, well, you better learn how to cook. Because if you don't know how to boil, look, I have a girlfriend that took 12 hours to boil one egg. I said, well, damn, what type an egg, are you boiling an ostrich egg? What person in your mind, I don't know what type of potato salad you're making with one egg. I mean, and then you're taking 12 hours to cook it. I'm like, where the hell did that egg come from? So it does not take 12 hours to cook an egg. But you got people who will put it in a crock pot and think that it's, you know, it's supper time at the old corral. I don't really know. But see, I come from the old school. Mama taught me how to cook on a step stool at the age of 5. I was learning, I was dicing and slicing then. And daddy took so far to teach me how to work the grill on the outside of the house. So I got it from all over. And as my career and my life, you know, I learned how to do Chinese food. I learned how to do Mexican food. I learned how to do Italian food. It's not too many dishes that I don't know how to do at this point. If you guys ever get a chance to visit my home, once I get it completely remodeled, you will see I have a spice rack of 172 spices in my basement on racks and shelves and jars and stuff, because whenever I get into that mood to cook something, like I say, I'll take it to the next level. But anyway, the items that you must have is cinnamon. Cinnamon is a fat burner. It will burn anything. You have to blend it in your regular food consumption and other oils, like, you know, your vegetable oils, you have your peanut oils, you have your olive oil. Now, olive oil is also good. You may want to blend that in as well. But the main source for losing weight, and you're losing weight as you sleep and you don't do anything different in your life, is using the coconut oil. Okay. Now, I guess I got that out the way. Let me see what else I need to talk about here. Let's see what else. Because I gotta have my list up here. I told you I talked about that. See, I gotta make sure that I'm on point with everything. Does anybody have any questions, comments, or concerns? I'm gonna go in the chat room in just a bit. But like I said, also here is a little bit of a notification. Classes, fall classes will be opening up as of September the 1st. There are the opening, people have asked me when I'm going to have the power of the pen. We had started the power of the pen and talking about reparations. Everybody wanted to learn about the power of the pen, the code of silence, and reparation. And I had started a class in the summertime, which started back in July, and we are doing quite well. And my students, I mean, these guys are the best. These guys are learning what they need to learn, and they're taking the skills and using it to their advantage, but we still got a lot. They still got a lot more information to learn. But what I wanted to tell everybody is that yes, I do teach. And for anybody that's interested in learning about the power of the pen, the classes will be opening up as of September the 1st for October class to start. This class that I'm teaching now, they won't be done until next summer. So I wanted to let that know. Anybody that was interested in participating in the class, everything will be right there. Also, anybody that's interested in placing a donation for the Queen of Radio, I have my own PayPal link. And if you donate anything over $40, you automatically get a gift card. Gift card certificate for a hotel stay by sponsors. Just to let you know that this is going to be the same thing that we're going to be giving away in September. Matter of fact, the second week of September. So it doesn't matter whether you signed up. If you want to subscribe to the channel, we're still going to be giving that away, that for 1 week only, to be exact. We're going to be giving away free hotel stay within the United States continent. That will be the second week, whether you are currently a subscriber or a new subscriber coming in. It's gonna be for everybody. everybody for that particular week. So that's the reason why I say you guys got to come on in and you got to join us and join the party. And don't forget, like I said before, the comment page, guys, that's your page. You can leave whatever type of message for Jay. You can talk whatever you got, whatever's on your mind. Go ahead, you can tell us if you like what you like about the show, what you would like to see on the show. Is there a particular guest that you would like for us to interview on the show? That is an open public page. That page is for you guys. It's not for me. So if you want to go ahead and write your comments, and again, like I said, for all the thumbs up means that you want to continue to see me to be on this program, on this platform, giving you these videos twice a week. I am on Thursday nights at 7:30 Central Standard Time, and I'm also on Sunday nights, 7:30 Standard Time. And again, the music, I will continue to bring you guys music on all of the live shows. The music will be changed, however, when the production company does the editing. So, because they want to be able to get it out there and in a lot more other places. So, go ahead and share this video. Let your friends know that I am the original Queen of Radio. And you can reach me at atorclass101@gmail.com. Again, all of this will also be in the description. That's atorclass101. We're going to chop it up about Mr. Wallace's case. We're going to give everybody our 2 cents, and I want you guys to come in and make your comments. Whatever you want to talk about, because like I said, if it's no you, it can't be no me. So, you know, we got to have each other. Now, with that being said, I'm going to go over to my chat room and see what's going on over here. I think everybody's pretty quiet. If you guys are in the trenches, don't be afraid. Come on down. Come on down. Get in the chat room and say hello. Let me know where you are listening from. Are you listening from New York City? Are you listening from Tennessee? Are you listening from Texas? Are you listening from Chicago? Where are you coming in from? Are you listening from or the Caribbean? Where are you coming in from? Just let me know where you're coming in from. And I said, Big Black is in the building. Hello, Big Black. And good to see you and hear from you again. Deborah says it's the throwback Thursday. Yes, ma'am. It's the throwback because we always have the wonderful music. And you know what, guys? I'm going to give you guys some more music. Getting off of here because, you know, I don't do the 9-10 hour thing. I just don't do the 9-10 hour thing. I don't know what people have to talk about for 9 or 10 hours, but I can't do the 9 or 10 hour thing. And that was a devil's egg. She said my friend must have been boiling a devil egg for her to be boiling that egg for 12 hours. Yeah, that sister put that egg in that pot. And she turned it on at 12 noon. And she said, oh, my goodness, I forgot to turn the pot off. And I said, well, what in the world were you cooking in the first place? She said, I had an egg. I said, wait a minute. You took the crock pot and you turned that pot on crock pot and you left that one egg in that pot. Oh, my goodness. You're probably right. That probably was the devil's egg. She said, that'll never get done. But anyway, okay. Is there any more comments, questions, or concerns before I get up out of here? I'm telling you guys have absolutely. I see y'all coming. I see their people are sending me their email. They're sending me messages through the email. I see the emails. I'll be there in just a bit. But right now I'm on live, so I can't get to your emails just yet. I see the emails are coming in at the top of my billboard here. But anyway. I hope I have been very informative. I hope that you guys can take some of the information that I have shared this evening and applied it to your own personal life. That's what I try to do. I try to keep it to be informed for all adults that are concerned. Okay. if I'm gonna say I'm going once, I'm going twice, I'm going three times. For any more comments, questions, or concerns, she say, that's your gardener. The gardener. Okay, we're not going to talk about it. Wow, the gardener. I'm going to tell you something about my gardener. My gardener is a very cutie pie. Yes, he is. He's a cutie pie, but I got to stay away from the gardener. I really do. That young man would be in trouble if I ever decided to, you know, to go that other way. I have to play that song by Minnie Riperton, Back Down Memory Lane. So, no, I'm not. My gardener is about 36, 37 with, you know, with abs. And he make me sick, too, when he comes over to try to cut the grass. Be trying to come over and cut the grass with no shirt on and stuff. And I'm like, okay, you keep playing around, boy. You're gonna get what the devil won't get around from. I'm trying to tell you, you better leave that thing. You better leave it alone, boy. I'm trying to tell you, better leave it alone. So, but anyway, he is, you know, yeah, the gardener is a very handsome little devil. Little 36, 37-year-old boy. I'm like, boy, if I can remember what the hell to do with you. If I can remember what the hell to do, he would be in trouble. That's all I'm saying. But no, I'm not going. No, this is not how Stella got her groove back. No. I gotta keep it in my own age bracket, you know, to slow it down. You know, but no, I can't move and mess with them little young bucks. Them little young bucks I will have those young bucks sprung. And I just can't have that. You know, I'm in that 50 category, and I just don't do. I'm just that's all I'm gonna say. I just don't do. Okay, and we're just gonna leave that at that. So with that being said, let me pull up my music. I don't see any more questions, comments, or concerns. Nobody wanted to come out of the trenches, and I see you guys in the trenches. Y'all ain't fooling nobody. I see y'all in the trenches, but I love you. I really do. I love each and every one of you for being in the trenches. Deborah said he grows the best potatoes. Good with steak, girl. Don't even talk about my steak. I'm trying to tell you, my steak is soaking in some, it's flaky, soaking in some gravy. You know that brown onion gravy? Ooh, I'm telling y'all, shut the front door. Get that steak and potatoes or that pot roast and put it with, you know, you remember how they used to say my mama's biscuits? Quit playing. Yeah, y'all better quit playing. So anyway, got to have that steak and potatoes, and I'm talking that flaky steak. I ain't talking about that kind of steak that you need 12 knives in order to cut that puppy. You know, you should have given that steak back to the cow that it came from. Okay. Anyway, let me see what music I'm gonna get ready to play for y'all so y'all can get out of here. Let me see. You know, we got to go back to so you guys are more than welcome to stick around to listen to the going out music. Because that, you know, you guys asked for this. You know, this is what you want. This is what I'm gonna give you. Y'all asked for the queen of radio to pump it up when I come in, and y'all asked me to pump it up when I go. So I'm gonna get ready to pump it up and pump it out. As I get ready to get out of here, to give some more James Brown. You know, we on a James Brown motion and movement today. So I'm just gonna say, y'all know who I am. Y'all know I am the original queen of radio, a touch of reality, where we tend to give everyone a true and real reality check. It's all uncut. And never, ever duplicated. So I will see you guys back in the saddle on Sunday, 7:30 Central Time. I don't know what time that is where you're at, but we're gonna let James Brown. Oh yeah, we got some. Not only did we have some James Brown, But we got another little something I'm gonna put out there. Wait a minute. See, I like, you know, y'all know how I do. So I'm gonna give y'all some James Brown and some Fat Boys. Y'all remember the Fat Boys? Them boys were nothing nice back in the in their hip hop day. But I gotta mix it up with that. So I'm gonna say I bid you all peace, love, and double deuces, and I will be seeing you on Sunday. All right, y'all. You all take care and have a pleasant good night. Let me see if I can pull it up. There you go.
Fellas, I'm ready to get up and do my thing.
Sex machine.
I want to get into it, man, you know. Like a sex machine, man. Moving, doing it, you know. Can I count it off? 1, 2, 3, 4. Get on up, get up, get on up, stay on the scene, get on up, like a sex machine, get on up, get up, get on up, get up, get on up, stay on the scene, get on up, like a sex machine, get on up, get up, get on up, stay on the scene, get on up, like a sex machine, get on up. Wait a minute, shake your arm, then use your palm. Stay on the scene, like a sex machine. You got to have the feeling, sugar bone. Get a tickle, right on, right on. Get up, get on up. Get up, get on up. Get up, get up.
Get up!
get on it. Get up. Get on it. Get up. Get on it.
Question, you ready to take it to the bed?
Yeah.
I said, ain't you ready to take it to the bed?
Yeah.
Chris Rocky. Ain't you ready to take it to the bed?
Yeah.
I said, ain't you ready to take it to the bed?
I said, yeah, boy.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Get up, fuck.
Get on up.
I say, get up, fuck.
Get on up.
I say, stay on the scene.
Get on up.
I like the sex machine.
Get on up.
Come on. Get up, fuck.
Get on up.
I say, get up, fuck.
Get on up.
I say, stay on the scene.
Get on up.
I like a sex machine.
Get on up.
Take a seat. Ladies on the floor, shaking their bodies. Fellas going down, looking for a party. The weekend's here, and it's time to get loose. You're sitting around, let the cook get through. 5 days, your day, you wait a whole week long. You dance to a slow or fast paced song. The beat is playing, the people are swaying. To get a freak on the floor, you keep praying. Now it's your turn to do your thing. To get on the floor and you start to swing. The freak of the dream, acting for a dance. You know, in the club, acting to your old man.
Get up,
get on up. I say, I get up.